Hello, Ultimate Success Tubers, and welcome back to Let's Play Shining Force 2 with me, BlueAnkylo. In case you didn't watch the last episode, you really should. It was perhaps my best victory in Shining Force 2 ever. This is probably the hardest battle in the game, at least to win without a death. And that's what we did, so huzzah to all. Anyway, today, now that we've got this balloon thingamajigger here, Puffball Cotton Balloon, that's the one. We can go to the Floor Kingdom, which is a totally different place. You should give me an army. Yeah, I think they should just build a ladder, but still. We did it. And... Yeah, I don't think there's too much new to be said, but maybe. Thought he might mention that we did awesome fighting, because he's a fighter too, but... Alright, anyway, we got the cotton balloon thingamajigger. Talk to this guy. Watch out for Floor World. I guess, you know, the Floor World might be dangerous. Like, you could be stepped on, literally. The desktop is probably safer. I had a hard time figuring this out when I was a kid, because I was... I don't know, I just never thought to use the item in the inventory. I couldn't figure out how to get down. So, one of the rare situations in this game where you actually have to select an item on the map screen. Alright, so, welcome to the floor. There's no going back, so you can't just climb up that. You might want to remember about that, though. So, somewhere on the floor, there's just a ring line. But you can't pick it up. So, the floor world, right, I'm pretty sure you can't climb back up. As much as there's like a ladder here, you can't climb it. It's actually not a very large world, and you could probably miss everyone here very easily. Yeah, but that's why we're here, right, yes. A hole in the wall, but don't use it. Why? Devil's in the tunnel. Maybe if you joined us, we could help you break out. Don't worry about it, guys. We're just gonna fight out on our own. So at least they give you a place where your caravan catches up and you can save and revive people. The next battle is also quite tough for a different reason than the last one, but we also changed the music here. That's kind of fun. Same, we're on the same Floor World map, but the we're on like a happy... castle music. Randolph is the gruff-looking guy with the axe. He is also a warrior like Jaha, but don't really compare the two much because they're completely different. Anyway, that's it. Basically, you know, four people. Maybe the priest counts as five. So, we'll just go through this tunnel full of devils, apparently. We've killed our share of devils. It smells like a ditch. Uh-oh. Oh no, giant rats! I guess, technically, they're just normal-sized rats, because we're the ones that are small. So, realistically, we should just normally kill them. Wilbur is specifically the thing that makes this battle hard is this guy here. Willard has stupid attack power and is very, very fast. Now, you could win this one probably not too difficultly, because you can kill everything else and then focus down Wilbur, but he'll almost certainly kill someone on your team. I think winning this battle without a loss is almost as hard as the previous battle. The difference is you can kind of fight the enemy less in group, more in sort of a couple at a time. The rats themselves aren't that bad, and then the oozes should be a little bit less strong. But these guys have a magical attack, or a bubbling attack, that ignores your defense. So if you brought Kiwi along, I don't know why, these guys can one-shot him. So, there's that. This level just happens to be the level that I usually level grind up and promote on. I get everyone up to whatever level you can get fighting these guys, and then I basically promote at the next opportunity. The secret is not particularly hard to figure out. The thing is, before the next scripted battle, we will be able to buy better weapons, but they're only for promoted classes. So this is a good time to get to whatever unpromoted class you want to get to, or unpromoted level you want to get to. I'm not really blocking this up the way I should be. I know I've had better strategies here. See, I think I spent all of my brain power on the chess battle last episode, which again, if you didn't watch it, go back and watch it right now. It was amazing. It's a little long, don't get me wrong. I'm such a poet. I think it was a good fight because it's a really, really tough battle, and we did a stellar job, one would say. And don't look at the small amount of level grinding I did to get there. It's a tough battle regardless. 30 damage, huh? Chester, I'm not impressed. But yeah, basically, we are getting to the point where being unpromoted is a serious disadvantage. Okay, Slade with the Protect Ring. I guess the oozes aren't that bad. Their only trouble is if they get a bubbling attack. This thing, Bubble Breath. So that will do 15 damage basically no matter what your defense is. So a low defense unit, that's just actually maybe a good thing. But for somebody like Kiwi, if he's got good defense, or Jaha, or anyone with good defense basically, Rick, those... Yes! Slade! With the big hit! So you could definitely get to level 27 fighting them without much trouble. Just trying to figure out what level I usually grind into here. Maybe 27 or so, seeing as that's a good point. Sounds like a good point. I'm not going to get a ton of hits on this rat, so maybe focus him down a little bit with magic. But yeah, these rats are a higher level themselves than the chess pieces were, other than the king. So level grinding on the king is kind of silly, or level grinding on chess is a little bit silly because you're about to have another battle with a better spot to grind in. This entry point here is much safer than the beginning of the fight against the chess. Luke might die. Oof. Like, Sarah hasn't even had a turn yet, so, like, come on, guys. Well, she had one turn, but, like, since we started getting attacked, she hasn't had a chance to heal. But my point is, you don't get swarmed here nearly so badly, so, it's a lot easier to get everyone a couple hits. Like, if you're trying to get a specific person a kill here, it's much, much easier than in that previous battle. She's gonna move out of the way in case we miss, and then someone else can move in and hit it. 40 experience. So yeah, 27 easily. Probably could get to level 28 then without too much trouble. But, I mean, we kind of outnumber them this time around, so it's nice. This is a nice change of pace. It's still it's not an easy battle, I wouldn't say, but compared to the chess battle, this one's so much nicer. So much harder to just get swarmed and have your hero killed. Now, if you put your hero anywhere near Wilbur, he might get killed. Wilbur gets a lot of turns. I suppose, also, you don't usually get, you might be running low on healing drops for this level. So that might be a problem. If you used a lot during the chess fight. Wow, Luke got wrecked. I could use a more powerful healing spell to heal him up 30, but, you know. I think the min-maxer in me just couldn't allow it. It's a waste of MP. Just to save a little bit of time for probably no benefit. I want to save a spot behind them in case something moves in. No, I don't think anything's going to move and attack this turn. Ah, I was wrong, but we have a spot behind Gerhalt anyway. Yeah, those guys usually start rushing up around this part of the map. Elric will continue to be terrible forever. Never expect anything out of Elric. It's basically in his name. Elric. Eric is pretty cool. Elrond is pretty cool. Elric. What's that? What's that supposed to mean? I'm trying to keep somebody like Rick up front in the defensive terrain. So if someone hits him, he shouldn't take too much damage. And Slade, I just couldn't resist. Bird Battler. He's actually a Birdman. I think the promotion is Bird Battler, though. Or something lame like that. I don't know. I don't really like the Birdman very much in these games. I have other classes I like a lot more. Like Wereman, Wolfman, or Werewolfman, or whatever. It's way cooler. So, like, if you're wondering, my first cut is going to be Elric, and my second cut is almost definitely going to be Luke. And if I have to cut more people, I'm going to be looking real close at Chester. And who else? Jaha, maybe. He hasn't been terribly effective. I would warn you at this point in the battle not to move forward too much. Be a little bit cautious, or else you'll pull Willard, and Willard will kill you. So maybe, you know, let them get an extra attack in like that, but don't get Willard. It hurts, but it doesn't hurt as much. Come on, mage. Show me you're awesome. It's pretty good. I think it might be because the rats and the oozes have fairly low defense that I like this fight. But I do remember, like, myself grinding on this level a lot in the past. I think it's my typical grind up and then promote battle, just personally speaking. And I think maybe it's because, like, low defense enemies, they take more damage, therefore you kind of can get more experience out of them quicker, because you get, like, more, like, you get experience points per damage dealt, which will add up quicker like this. So I'm a little bit worried about Jaha here. I need to open a path so we can start moving forward. Actually, that was the wrong unit to attack with Rick, because of where he was standing. I should have maybe killed one of the guys that only he could hit with a ranged attack. Oh, I thought it was going to go. Oh no, these guys, they got a turn. I was going to pull Jaha out of the way, but he never got a turn. Well, that's his bad luck, I guess. I mean, I was almost happy because I thought one of the rats was going to attack Gerhalt and cause problems, but... Oh, well. Yeah, let's keep myself alive. Staying alive. Sometimes the order of battle is just, you can't beat it. And sometimes your Phoenix is just awesome. I think all times your Phoenix is awesome. Right, so if both rats had attacked Geralt, he would have been dead. Let's make sure the ooze can't attack him and finish him off. Mage should have a kill here. So we had one unit go down. I'm a little bit disappointed about that. But it was a lot of bad... It was quite a lot bad luck. I mean, simply put, Jaha didn't get a turn to move out of the way like I was expecting, or Sarah had no chance to heal him, so... Because of random turn order, sometimes you sort of miss your turn until much later in the round. I don't want Slade to die. It's actually mostly pointless for Rick to get that hit in. Because he's level 27, he doesn't really need the kills. Now, if Sarah doesn't get a turn, Geralt will probably die. But he got his level up. That's what counts. This is going to draw in Willard, though. We're just going to try to protect Geralt. With fleshy bird bones. Oh, he didn't attack. Okay, that is really lucky. Okay. Nice. Very nice. Willard pulled back and gave me a chance to consolidate a little bit. Consolidate power. Well, I don't think they'll go after Elric. They might. I'm divvying up my damage rather than finishing things off. Which, it's that experience min-maxing that gets me into a bit of trouble. It's only a good idea if you can, not lose units off of it, basically. Well, I mean, you don't lose them permanently anyway, so. But if you're going for a no-loss run, you should probably be a little bit more careful about finishing enemy units, rather than damaging a bunch and trying to let specific characters get extra experience. I don't think Elric can kill that, but might as well let him shoot it. To be fair, after this battle, we'll never see Elric again. Because we're dropping him off in a ditch. Alright, we're gonna move Bird up. So there's more room for the rest of the team to attack. I have a feeling Willard could one-shot Slade. Maybe Sarah should heal him. Oh, that's kinda... Well, now you can definitely one-shot him. Almost certainly. I wanna move Geralt up either. Of the current units, yeah, I'd rather it was Rick that took the hit. Rick's got pretty good defense, so if the Willard can go after Rick, then maybe I can kill it before he gets another attack. I think Kazim can kill it with Blaze 3, so might as well. It's been a pretty good battle, other than Jaha, of course. I really don't know why. I guess, like, maybe I put Jaha up front more often than I should, I guess. He'll probably go after Elric if he's in range. Alright, goes after me. Now, I just need Sarah to heal me before it gets another action. So, I'm definitely using heal level 3 in this situation. Because Willard can get two attacks per turn, and I think he always gets two attacks per turn, or at least usually does. We gotta stay topped up. Besides, there you go, Sarah. Have a level up. Alright, now focus fire. If I can kill him without having anyone go down via him killing them, that's pretty awesome. Yay, Elric got a level up. There's his second attack. Oh, he went for Elric? I thought he'd go for me. Definitely not what I was expecting. And he got his second attack really quickly together, too, so... I think we should get most of the team a turn now before he gets another chance. So I'm okay putting my feeble damage thief next to him. Although a counter might kill him. You should consider that as well, perhaps. Would a counter attack kill your dude? But yeah, I think he's done. Yeah, you know, Geralt, you deserve another win. I think Geralt got the king last battle, too. Totally awesome. Good work, Wereman, Wolfman, Beast Dude. That went pretty well. I mean, it wasn't perfect. But, Jaha's been kind of a weak link in the team for a long time, so it can't surprise me that much. Anyway, let's go progress the story a little bit. Oh look, there's money there. I assume that's where Willard sort of hung out on that carpet with a coin on it. And he's been storing all this other money. It's probably like, you know, 10 bucks. But to a rat, he thinks he's a rat king with all that money. Alright. Escaped! Now what do? We're still teeny tiny. So, this is Creed, in case you didn't catch it a couple episodes ago. Yeah, we killed all the chests, we killed all the mice, or the rats. We actually did you a favor, we removed the rodents from beneath your chest room. I don't know what this room is. His library, maybe? Probably a library. Maybe Goliath was supposed to tell him about this? You smack him good, Creed. Did you put a sign on the magic door? Did you lock the magic door? I told you to lock that door. That's right. Alright. So we would have been freed anyway, right? We would just have to wait a little while. No, you didn't hear anything. Shh. Hey there, Mr. Creed. Yeah, we just wanted to visit, really. And then, of course, they did have this terrible idea of breaking in. Don't mention that part, maybe. Right, I do remember something about a break and enter plan. Abracadabra 123. Wow, that's all it takes to do magic, guys. I'm a magician. Ah, much better. Tired of being small, for sure. So, Peter and Audler, you're on a short lease from now on. We're not listening to you anymore. Breaking in was a terrible idea. Oh, hey! Fairies! Right. Xeon, I should be listening to this, right? Maybe? Well, you see... Noisy fairy, be quiet. Knocks her out of the way. Yeah, I'm pretty sure... Well, I mean, we haven't seen Xeon, but, like, Volcanion was pretty sure. Is that what he does? Oh. Because he's a wizard! Wizard always knows. Now get out of the way, Goliath. I don't know anything about that, actually. North Paramecia has had no rain. We've got clouds. So basically you're telling me that Grand's Island is stealing all of the rain and precipitation in the planet to cause a drought everywhere else. I wonder where Matula is. So, if you haven't, let's just say you've never played the game, and you've also never watched a full playthrough of it. If you're just watching along, and this is your first time seeing Shining Forest 2, I will give you the jackpot prize of, oh man, I'll go all in, 1,000,000 BlueAnkylo points, if, without any outside information, you can guess who Matula is in the comments right now. And I will give you but one hint that in this current Let's Play series on footage, we have seen her speak. And that is the only tip you get. If you have to look it up and then you leave a comment and you try to get 1,000,000 points from that, then You are cursed for all eternity for being a cheat. So you have to do it fair. They're invulnerable to everything except Zeon. Well, that's... it's a bad thing Zeon escaped. I guess. Maybe we should have left him sealed. Yeah. So there's a devil that can destroy, or at least damage, gods. I don't know if you could kill them necessarily, but... pretty bad news, you could say. Goliath, I blame you for everything. Except for everything Slade did. And everything Peter and Audler did. So I blame a lot of things on a lot of people, basically. Except me. I've been doing good work. Basic rules of possession. Oh. That sounds... gods versus devils. Wow, such amazing literature. Today's Magic. I wonder who wrote that book. Study of Runes. Okay, that's reasonable. Call of Evil. Wait a second. I thought this guy was an ex-demon devil guy. Vampires? There's no vampires in this game. Newt cooking. Well, sure. Whatever floats your boat. Tickles your pickle. Demon kings. Sure. I guess that's useful. Magical changes. Yeah, like turning people into midgets, or even smaller than midgets, turning people into figurine level. Evil Contact. So he's got a lot of evil books. And he's got evil music playing in his basement, which turns into a giant lava fortress. I'm sure this guy is good? Okay, speaking gibberty gook. Oh good, let's summon the evil spirit. That's a great idea. Thanks, Creed. Just summon an evil spirit. Why are we summoning the evil spirit first? Maybe we should talk about this. What do you want? King of the Devils, huh? So you're gonna use your evil spirit to spy on the King of the Devils. Wouldn't King of the Devils trump the evil spirit and make him one of his minions? I don't know, guys. This seems fishy. Okay. Cerebro, go. So there's a barrier around Grand, so that's also fishy. Something that belongs to Zeon, you say. Does that belong to him? I thought it was part of the jewels that sealed him. Yeah. No. Well, that's probably a bad... no, hold on, guys. This guy is an ex-greater devil. Maybe handing over the jewels is a bad idea. See? I'll teach him. Well, yeah, what? Good. I didn't want you to take them out of my neck. I'm getting used to them. Looks stylish. Look at my pretty jewelry in my neck. It's gonna be a fashion craze. All the kids are doing it. Whoa, it's trippy. What's going on with the color of the screen, guys? Okay, so confirmation. That's bad. Yeah, that's definitely bad. Flying devils. North Parmesia. So you mean the monsters will be stronger in North Parmesia than self, because that's where the devils are going. And lots of flying devils, too. Ah, the old big bad, not at full strength routine. He's definitely a mischief maker. I think Creed should know exactly how powerful he is. His power... Okay, disconnect. Unplug. Unplug it, I said. Someone turned it off. This is not what I signed up for. Guys, we should seriously consider turning this off. Look, he's getting information about us now. Yeah, just unplug it. It's not impossible. No, I'm not blue. I don't know what you're talking about, Zeon. Never heard of Ellis. Now he knows who we are, guys. This is terrible. Creed, what have you done? Doesn't look good. You needed a more evil spirit. Or maybe just a less evil spirit that wasn't evil. Yeah, that would be... That's his power. So you try to spy on him with evil spirits, and he explodes them. Well, maybe you should listen to me. How reliable was the evil spirit? I rate him 7 out of 10 on the reliability scale. No more questions. So, what have we really accomplished here? We talked to Creed because he's supposed to know about Zeon. He didn't really know much about Zeon, but he had an evil spirit in the basement that he could use to spy on the King Zeon or whatever. We spied on him a little bit, but then he spied on us and killed evil spirit. It's not been a very good day. At least we're not tiny. So I guess it's not all bad. Maybe. So Tristan. Okay, that's something. But we're probably gonna go to North Paramecia anyway. Alright, I getcha. Oh yeah, by the way, fairy, there's a dwarf that was sick. I totally remembered that. So we'll just take the fairy with us to go help out the dwarf. See, again, he says he'd like to help us, but he only wants to help a little tiny bit. Choose one. You can't choose all four of these. We have probably the best knight in the game, pretty assuredly the best warrior in the game, pretty assuredly the best sorcerer mage in the game, and definitely the best cleric in the game, or priest. You only get to pick one, though. Now, technically, later on in the game, you can come back and get the other three. These guys are all level 24, by the way, so they're basically the same level as us. A couple levels lower, whatever. Whoever we pick, you'll get right now, and they will help you through the rest of the game, if you use them. And you can get the other three, whichever you don't pick, kind of, I think there's like six or seven battles left in the game when you can pick them up, somewhere around that. But they're still at level 24 unpromoted, whereas you'll be promoted at level 20, 25. So you'd have to really, really try hard to catch them up. So if you wanted to use all four in the final battle, for instance, probably should pick Randolph. Because it's easier to level up the other three. Healers level up pretty easy because they can just heal stuff. And Karna especially has a spell that really makes that easy. Tyrant with magic means he can finish stuff off pretty easily at a very high... Like, even if he's at a low level, he can deal strict damage to enemies because it doesn't count their defense. Whereas the fighters, if they only have 40 attack power and the enemies have, like, 80 defense, they can't really do anything. At least... As a knight, he can use ranged attacks with a spear to keep himself safe, whereas our warrior has to get up front. So it's a lot harder to level these guys up. So pick one of them if you want to use everybody. I usually don't care much about Eric and Randolph because, well, I don't know. I've got lots of fighters. I've got two knights right now, even if Eric's better. So he would replace one of the knights. And I've got a warrior he's still kind of slow. I don't really like Randolph very much. I don't like warriors very much. On the other hand, I only have one mage, and I only have one priest. Sarah's great, don't get me wrong. Karna is better at healing. Kazin is actually not a very good mage. The only spell I use regularly is Blaze. Desol only works sometimes. Muddle Dispel only works sometimes. Even if their status effects are valuable, it still just never seems to apply when I need it. So, can't count on it. At least Blaze you can count on. Tyrant gets Blaze, Freeze, and Bolt. And I think Desol as well, if you like that sort of thing. Although, one of them can be promoted to a different class, and then we can talk about that soon, but the point is, if you want the rest of the game to be easy, you should probably pick Karna. Having another healer, even if she only had heal like Sarah, would make the rest of the game much, much easier in the next few battles. Because it's still quite a few battles away before we get another healer naturally. And a really long way until we get another wizard type class naturally. Like, the game is really short on... the first half of the game is really short on priests and mages. But I'm going to pick... Because I'm playing on... ouch difficulty. Super difficulty is actually harder, generally speaking, because the attack power is so high. In that case, I would maybe take Karna because it would make it a little bit easier. And she's the easiest. She makes the game the easiest. But I'm going to pick Tyrin because, for one, we're short on ranged magical units. And for two, I don't want it to be as easy as possible. And I'm not going to pick those two because I don't like them. They might be more unique, like there might not be very many Let's Plays of Shining Force 2 where you pick those guys, because who picks them? But we're going with Tyrin. He studied in Pompeii. That's the place that got blown up by probably a volcano. And spoiler alert, I'm probably picking Karna up at the end of the game and leveling her up to be my second healer. Unfortunately, we won't be able to pick her up for a long time. I believe there are mods, there's quite a lot of mods for this game, or patches, that I think there's one or two that might allow you to recruit all four, which is what I always wanted in life. So anyway, we've got Tyrin. He starts with Blaze 2 and Freeze 2, so he's already better than Kazan, basically. We're not going to talk about promotions yet, but soon. There's some choices to be made promotion-wise as well. Sure. Well, if you want to stay. I mean, he hasn't really helped us much, to be fair. Kind of got me in trouble with that break-in scheme him and Peter came up with. If you want to stay, maybe he can teach you how to see magically or something. Alright. Oh, you know what? I just missed something. Oh, no. I don't remember if I can go back in this building right now. Oh, no. Maybe, I hope I can go back in. Remember that ring that was on the floor? Oh, no. I think he blocks the door. I really need that ring. Oh, I made a terrible mistake. Let's see if we leave and come back in. I will actually have to redo, not the episode, I'll redo the battle. Okay, we can go back in. Whew! I thought we'd be locked out. Alright, remember? Before we end the episode, remember that part on the floor where there was a ring lying there? It's a really important ring. Oh, you actually have to be facing the bottom floor. This one? There we go. You don't have to use the search command, you just have to press C. So the running ring is... Well, I think hands down the best ring in the game. So what that does is... This thing gives you +2 movement to anyone on the force. No attack or defense, just mobility or movement. I'm just going to throw it on Gerhalt for now. I'm actually not 100% sure if I'm going to keep Gerhalt. I can give the running ring to anyone. The running pimento does the same thing, but it's permanent. The ring just lets you switch it around however you like. It works really good on units like Gerhalt and Jaha or Randolph, units like that. It's also pretty good on your healers, because then they can catch up and heal, or like basically anyone with 5 movement. There are actually two for sure, units with 4 movement that you'll get later on, and we'll probably never use them. But if you want to use them, you're going to want to save a running pimento or the... You might even want to use 2, like a running pimento and the ring on them, to bring them up from 4 to 8, which is pretty awesome. I think there's something out here, before we leave. Maybe? I thought there was something... Maybe in the garden. Yeah, antidotes. Not very valuable, yeah. So he grows antidotes. I think that's all there is in Creed's mansion, though. The important thing, specifically, was getting that mobility ring. And I was worried that we weren't going to be able to get out, so... Okay, we're going to end the episode here. And next episode, we are going to head back to New Grand Seal and see how things are going. We'll get Jaha resurrected. I'll switch the party up. Spoiler alert, Elric is getting benched and Tyran's on the team. And we're going to hope that Tyran can prove that he was worth bringing along over Karna. Because Karna, the priest, is pretty amazing. And I would have loved to show her off as well, but we can only pick one, so that's what I did. Thanks for watching, folks. Hope you've enjoyed, and have a great day.